Milwaukee M18 batteries are notorious for only charging to 3 bars due to cell imbalance. This is despite their batteries having a microcontroller and an analog front end with balancing built in. The analog front end does a number of tasks that the microcontroller isn't suited to. Balancing is achieved by turning on these transistors, which creates a small circuit that can discharge a single cell. These resistors are 1 kilo-ohm, so the balancing current will only be 2 milliamps. This is quite slow when trying to balance 12,000 milliamp hours of capacity. The transistors are rated for 50 milliamps, so they could be using 2 40 ohm resistors for faster balancing, but it would mean using bigger resistors. To see when balancing happens, we strap the battery down to this totally consensual interrogation table and stick some custom electrical probes in it. From Quagmire Repair's excellent teardown, we know that we need to probe the R6 and R8 resistors. Now we can eavesdrop on everything that these two chips are saying to each other. The entire communication method is documented in the datasheet, so there's no need to reverse engineer anything, we know exactly what they're saying. The communication protocol is called I2C. The microcontroller tries to The microcontroller initiates all communication and the analog front end submits, waits for commands, and then acts on them. Each command consists of an address to the register that the microcontroller is interested in and whether it wants to spank and whether it wants to read or write to that register. To save overhead, the device and register address are packed into one byte. So to decode these messages, we have to subtract 20 from the address, but I find it easier to just add 20 to the register map. The address byte is followed by a data byte and then a checksum, which we can ignore. After every write command, the microcontroller reads the status register to make sure there were no checksum errors. As we know that everything is totally consensual, we can just filter all of those messages out. I tested a 2 amp hour from 2016 and a 12 amp hour from 2019. The 12 amp hour is particularly unbalanced with a 0.6 volt difference between the highest and lowest cells. When the battery is idle, we just get the following sequence every 2.9 seconds. The command to the power control register enables the current sense, cell monitoring, thermistor, and reference voltage. It then commands VC out to show the voltage of all 5 cells one at a time. For some unknown reason, it asks for cell 1 twice. It then reads the config 2 register, which tells us a few properties. There's now another write to power control, which turns off all the voltage outputs to save power. Next is setting VC out to ground to save more power, and then it writes all zeros to the balance control register, which turns off all of the balancing transistors. So no balancing is happening when the battery is idle. Then there's 2 write commands to config 1 and config 2, and that's the end of the conversation. The simple version of this is that it powers the chip up, reads the cell voltages, then powers down. When you squeeze the trigger on a tool, the order changes slightly. It starts with power down, then does power up, then asks for the cell voltages. Again, it asks for cell 1 twice, then for some reason also asks for cell 4 twice. It then goes into a fast loop of measuring all the cells every 9.8 milliseconds. This time it only asks for cell 1 once, but keeps asking for cell 4 twice. It seems they've hard-coded these and someone got sloppy with their copy and pastes. We have previously reverse-engineered the charger to battery communication, so now we can also see what the microcontroller and analog front-end are saying between these messages. When the charger is turned on, they start with the power-down conversation. This includes turning all balancing off, so no balancing happens at the start of charging. Just before the charger introduces itself, they turn everything back on, and the microcontroller retrieves all the calibration information from the analog front end. After every message from the charger, the microcontroller measures the voltages of all 5 cells, and then gives its reply. They also finally get it right, and only ask for each cell once. Every 4th cycle, they also set VC out equal to half of VREF, which is most likely done to help the microcontroller correct for any temperature drift. When the charging switches from constant current mode to constant voltage, there is no change in the I2C comms, so there is no balancing happening during the constant voltage phase either. As the charge ends, they measure all the cells, then there's a small break, and they have the power down conversation. Then the battery tells the charger to finish. Again, the balance register is set to zero, so all balancing transistors are off and no balancing is happening. After this, the charger checks on the battery every 3 seconds. Before replying, the microcontroller does the idle conversation, with the balance register set to zero every time. I left a battery on the charger for 40 minutes after the charging had finished to see if it was waiting for the battery to settle, but it was still setting the balance register to zero. So, what the f*** Milwaukee? My last video had me shocked that DeWalt doesn't balance charge. DeWalt at least has the excuse that they're too cheap, as they'd have to add extra components to their chargers. But Milwaukee has all the hardware needed, built into every M18 battery they've ever made, and they're too lazy to add 31 lines of code? I did it for them in a couple of hours, so I'll be happy to accept a finder's fee. Board shots of the latest Forge 12 amp hour only show the same small resistors, which isn't too promising. I might have to get my hands on their Forge batteries to see if they're still not balancing their latest and greatest. It will be pretty sad if they're not.